let us discuss different possible equations which describe stationary waves. Let the component waves for formation of a stationary wave are, which we already discussed, it is y1 is a sine of omega t minus kx, and another is traveling in opposite direction, which is a sine of omega t plus kx. When we combine these equations, or when these two simple harmonic waves superpose on a region of medium particles, the resulting equation for a stationary wave is, this can be given as, which we already studied, it is 2a cos kx sin omega t, where this 2a is the amplitude of antinode, which can be rewritten as a naught cos kx sin omega t. So in this situation, a naught cos kx is the amplitude of a medium particle located at a position x. Now this is the equation we are getting when these two waves superpose, but there might be some phase difference exists between the two waves. One can be this and the other wave can have an initial phase alpha, or the difference with first wave with respect to first wave it is alpha. Then in this situation the equation may change. Like if these equations are, see, these are given as y1 as a sine of omega t minus kx, and the other wave is a sine of omega t plus kx, and is having a phase difference pi with the first wave. Now in the situation when you combine these, it will be a sine omega t minus kx, and this will be minus a sine omega t plus kx. And combining these equations, we get a stationary wave as y is equals to 2a sin kx cos omega t, or this cos omega t can also be written as sin omega t plus pi by 2. So here we can say the forms can be changed. So based on the phase difference between the two waves, the possible equations we can write. So we can have possible equations for a stationary wave in a region. These can be written in two ways. It can be y is, either we can use a naught sin kx sin of omega t plus alpha, or we can write it a naught cos kx sin of omega t plus alpha. Here you can see the second term in the expression of a stationary wave equation is basically the sinusoidal factor, which is the factor deciding that medium particles are executing SHM, and the first part of this expression is the resulting amplitude of medium particle, which depends on its position. We can see it may be having a term of cos kx, it may be having a term of sin kx. It will just be decided by the location where nodes and antinodes are being produced. Let's see this. As discussed, we can write in general equation of a stationary wave can be given as y is equals to r sin of omega t plus alpha, where r is the amplitude of different medium particle oscillations, which depends on their position, where we can write here r can be written as a naught sin kx, or r can be written as a naught cos kx. In this situation, if r is a naught sin kx, this we use 1 at x equal to 0, there is a node. As we know, a node is a point where destructive interference takes place, or this is a point where we can say always the oscillation amplitude is 0. So in this situation, at x equals to 0, r will always be 0. And a naught cos kx we use when at x equals to 0, there is an antinode. Because antinode is the point where a medium particle oscillates with the maximum amplitude E naught. So here if we substitute x equals to 0, the value of R will be E naught. So depending on the selection of origin of the coordinate system corresponding to which we are writing the equation, we decide the value of R, which will choose either E naught sin kx or E naught cos kx. This is the way how we write the equations of simple harmonic stationary waves in a region.